the workbench Faraday cage measurement technique. For the electromagnetic emission characterization, we also discussed this thing, but in this case, it will, or it can also be used to characterize the immunity or how robust is our IC. The basic principle is exactly the same as for the electromagnetic emission, but now we are driving an RF interference current into our system, into our PCB, very often done by a signal generator in combination with a power amplifier. There is a coaxial cable which leads then into the Faraday cage that we have, and inside of the Faraday cage we have our printed circuit board, and on one edge of the printed circuit board we are injecting this RF interference, for example, into the power plane or into the ground plane, signal return plane. And the other edge of the printed circuit board is then connected also by a cable which cannot be seen that good here, and then connected to a 50 ohm termination. So we are forcing then a current through the ground plane on the printed circuit board, which causes a magnetic field around the ground traces and also a kind of voltage drop with some capacitive and inductive coupling. And as this printed circuit board is placed in a shielded box, we do not have some interference from the outside. So this is the basic principle of this workbench Faraday cage. I'm not sure if this measurement technique is used that often. So we made at the Institute maybe one or two measurements based on that. Because it really depends on where you are clamping the crocodile clamps on your printed circuit board and how you are driving this RF interference current through the whole printed circuit board.